Assalamu alaikum. Dear learners, I hope you are fine. This video will cover the basics of Boolean algebra required for ladder programming that will be used for programming a PLC. I'll quickly overview the range of things with a hope that learners already have some basic knowledge about logical operations. So let's start. The first logical operation and the simplest one is the NOT or negation operation. It is a single input operation that will flip the input at its output. If you'll provide it a 0, it will give you a 1, and if 1 is applied at the input, the output would be 0. The NOT operation is represented by a truth table shown over here. The ISO symbol for the NOT gate is this one, with this side being the input and the other as output. Moreover, this schematic shows how a NOT gate may be implemented electrically. The schematic presents a high voltage and a low voltage rail between which some components are attached. The current will flow from the high voltage rail to the ground or zero voltage rail. This particular representation will be helpful for us for producing standard industrial electrical drawings and even the ladder logic program for a PLC. The normally closed switch S1 represents the input of the NOT gate, whereas the output is represented by the H1. So, when there is no input, the normally closed switch will relay the power to the output and the output will be on. Whereas, if you press the switch S1, that is, turn on the switch, it will become open and hence disconnect the power to the output, turning it off. Hence, this simple electrical diagram represents the NOT operation. The second basic logical operation is of AND, or technically conjunction. This function is a two-input, single-output function and will give you a 1 or a high output only if both of the inputs are on. It's just like connecting two electrical switches in series and then connecting them to some actuator. If both switches are turned on, only then the actuator will receive power, otherwise it won't. The truth table for this operation is shown over here that shows that if both inputs are 1, only then the output will be 1, otherwise it will remain 0. The ISO symbol for logical AND function is shown over here with two inputs and one output. The third basic logical operation is of OR. It's once again a two input, one output operation. In fact, only NOT operation is a single input, single output function, while all of the rest are multi-input, single output functions. Anyhow, OR, or technically disjunction operation will give a high output if any one of the input goes high. It's like two switches connected in parallel to each other, supplying power to an actuator that is connected in series with these switches. If any of the switch is turned on, the power will flow to the actuator, causing it to operate. The truth table shown over here for disjunction function shows the same thing. That is, if both inputs are off, only then the output will be low or 0, otherwise it will be high. The ISO symbol for this function is shown over here with two inputs and a single output. Cutting things short, this table shows summary of logical operations. The second column contains the Boolean equation for each logic function. Note the symbol used for representing the functions. The third column shows the truth table for each function, whereas the fourth column contains the ISO symbol for corresponding functions. Moreover, the fifth, sixth, and the last column contains the pneumatic, electrical, and electronic circuit schematics used for implementing corresponding functions. This table lists the same things for two more logical functions, which are quite commonly used. However, are derivatives of the basic functions of NOT, AND, and OR. The first row contains the information related to exclusive OR function that will show a high output only if one of the input is high. The output will remain low or zero if both inputs are same, that is, both are on or both are off. The second row shows the information related to equivalence function that will give a high output if both inputs are same, otherwise it will give a low output. In fact, it is the opposite of exclusive OR function. Do have a look at the pneumatic, electrical, and electronic realizations of these functions as well. Lastly, this table shows the information of two more logical functions that are quite common in practice, that is the AND and the NOR operation. The name represents what these functions will do. AND is in fact the NOT operation applied to a conjunction or AND function, whereas NOR is the application of a NOT function to a disjunction or OR function. Real situations contain large number of inputs that are responsible for changing the state of the certain output. Therefore, implementing a Boolean equation through pneumatic, electrical, or electronic circuit requires that we first simplify the things and then implement the simplified version, or we need a Boolean expression that can be translated to a circuit by using basic logical functions. So there are two different ways that I'm going to talk about deriving the Boolean expression. The first one is through the use of truth table, and the second one is through the Karnaugh-Veitch diagrams, or sometimes called K-maps. Let's try to understand the method of deriving a simplified Boolean expression from truth table for a certain situation through an industrial example. Suppose that a manufacturing system manufactures small wooden panels. These panels need drilling at certain positions only. Once the drilling has been done, the correctly drilled panels are sent on one side, whereas if there is any missed or incomplete drilling hole, that panel is rejected. Drill holes can be at four corners of the panel, as shown over here on these four wooden panels. The sensors B1, B2, B3, and B4 detect the holes on four corners, and if there is a complete drill hole, the sensor gives a high output, otherwise it will give a zero. If the drilling hole matches what the specifications are, the actuator numbered as 1 should be actuated to push the panel on the sideways conveyor. So these are the desired positions of the drill holes. If any one of the shown door comes in front of the actuator should be actuated, hence pushing the panel to the sideways conveyor. Simplifying the requirement leaves us with four sensors, B1 to B4, whose output will decide whether the actuator should be actuated or not. So as the first step of solving this problem, we can easily encode this information in form of a truth table. The truth table shown over here has high output only if the four sensors give outputs corresponding to the desired drill holes in the panel. Sensors B1 to B4 are represented by letters A to D, and output is represented by the letter Y. For example, a wooden panel having drill hole only at the B4 position should be separated by actuating the actuator. That is why the second row corresponding to this situation has a high output. Moreover, a panel having holes at B2 and B4 should also be separated. B2 and B4 are represented by B and D. Therefore, it can be seen in the sixth row that the output is high if B and D are high. Similarly, high output is there for desired wooden panels as shown. So, now that we have made the truth table, we need a Boolean expression made up from basic logical operations so that we can implement this situation through pneumatic, electrical, or electronic means. To derive the Boolean expression directly from the truth table, there are two ways. The first one is called disjunctive standard form, or sum of products. What we want is that the output should be high if any one of the conditions listed in the truth table occurs. So we will say either this condition or this condition or this condition or any of these conditions become true, actuate the actuator. The first condition can be written as negation of A and with negation of B and with negation of C and with D. If you plug all values of this row into this expression, the expression is going to yield a 1. Similarly, all other conditions are written and then disjunction of these conditions is taken so that if at least one of the conditions become true, the overall output will become true. So dear learners, this is the expression that will represent the situation at hand, and we need to implement this Boolean expression to control the operation of the actuator. You must be wondering that this expression is quite long and might be quite difficult to implement. Well, you're right. Just like any complex mathematical expression can be simplified by using certain rules, Boolean expressions can also be simplified using Boolean algebra. But before moving to that, let me describe the second way through which Boolean expression may be derived directly through the truth table. The second way is called conjunctive standard form, or product of sums. In this form, we take disjunction of inputs that make zero output. That is, the conditions corresponding to zero output are written down in disjunctive form, but the inputs corresponding to 1 are negated. For example, the expression for the third row would be A or with B or with negation of C or with D. Similarly, writing expression for all 0 output scenarios and then taking conjunction of them will yield us with this long Boolean expression. No matter which way you have used, you will arrive at the same simplified expression. But it's logical to go with the way that is producing smaller Boolean expression to start with. For example, if there were more 1s in the output column than 0s, then the disjunction standard form would have generated a long equation, and conjunctive standard form would have generated a smaller equation. So in this particular example, the disjunctive standard form is simpler than this one. Therefore, it would be easier to simplify that one using Boolean algebra rules. This slide lists down the most used Boolean algebra laws, and learners are encouraged to go through these laws on their own, as it would be quite time taking for me to explain and prove them over here. The laws are not that difficult, and you can easily prove them by plugging values in them on your own. So using these laws, we can simplify the disjunctive standard form to arrive at a simplified version so that it may be implemented in hardware easily. For clarity, the conjunction symbols are removed. Over here, you can see that A, B, and D can be taken out as common, leaving us with C negation or with C. C negation or with C will always yield a 1. Therefore, it can be removed altogether. Similar thing can be done with these two expressions by taking A negation, C negation, and D common. And with these two expressions by taking A, B negation, and D common. So we can remove these portions as well and will be left with this expression. Now once again, we can take A and D common from these two expressions and then remove this portion as well. Now taking D common from these expressions, we will be left with this thing. Now using the distributive law, we can write this expression as A negation OR with A and C negation OR with A. Obviously, A negation OR with A can be removed once again, leaving us with this expression only. Opening this bracket will give us this equation, which is the simplified version of the long equation that we started with. Now to implement this Boolean expression, it's quite simple and straightforward in practice. So this is one method through which you can derive the simplified Boolean expression from the truth table for any situation. Now let's see the other method, that is of Karnaugh-Veitch diagram, or for short K-maps. For using K-maps, the first thing you need is a table having half of the inputs on the vertical side and half on the horizontal side as shown over here. Now each location of this table will correspond to a row in the truth table. The truth table rows have been numbered for your convenience. For example, you can see that the 7th location in the K-map has entries of A negation, B, C, and D negation. And if you see the 7th row in the truth table, then you will see the same thing, that is, A is low, B and C are high, and D is low. So now, the next step is to list the entries of the truth table in the K-map. So the output of the row 1 will go to the location 1 in the K-map, and similarly output of each row will go to the corresponding location in the K-map. At the end you will have this K-map. The next step is to group the cells having 1s in them, but the rule is that you can have groups that are continuous and comprise of either 2 cells, 4 cells, 8 cells, and so on. So following this rule, we can make 2 groups Y1 and Y2 as shown over here. Now we just need to figure out the expression for both groups and OR them together, because our output would be high if any one of the groups generate a high output. The simple way of generating expression for a group is to include the input that is not changing in the group. For example, in group Y1, you can see that if you move from cell to cell, C negation and D will appear in all of the cells, whereas input A and B are changing their values. That is why the expression of group Y1 would be C negation and D. Similarly, for group Y2, A, C, and D are remaining constant. Therefore, the expression would be A and C and D. Taking a disjunction of expressions corresponding to both groups will give us this expression. And this expression can be easily simplified using Boolean algebra laws to arrive at the same result that we came up through the other method. Learners should try to figure out the steps required for simplification of this Boolean expression on their own. So dear learners, you can see that no matter which method of deriving the Boolean expression we use, we should arrive at the same solution if we are doing the things right. So implementing this simplified expression requires one NOT gate, two AND gates, and an OR gate. And that's it. I hope now that you have an understanding that how practical situations can be converted to logical expressions and then simplify those expressions so that they can be implemented easily. That's all for this video. Thank you and take care.